So the IAM that I just mentioned, there's the option for virtual components. And you might think, okay, well, wait a minute, what are virtual components? Virtual components are components that you either cannot create a model of or you don't need to create a model of. So what are some examples of that? That it's components you want to have call out on a bill of material, but there's no model of it. There's no geometry. How do you get it to show up here? And one of the easiest ways to do that is to create a virtual component. That is what this option here does. Using the create command, when you check virtual component, you'll notice that the template selection is grayed out. Also, the file path gets grayed out. So you're not creating an actual file. You're creating more or less a call out in the bill of material. You're creating metadata that's associated with this particular assembly or with this assembly template. You do have a bill of material structure, so you can identify, is it a normal BOM structure? Is it a purchased item? Is it a phantom or a reference or something like that? So what are some examples of this? Some good examples of this are any kind of lubricants or grease that you might need to have called out in your assembly. But again, you can't really create a feasible model of grease. Another good example is any kind of maintenance manual or assembly manual. An extra parts bag or packet or something like that is another item. So if you want to incorporate these into your template, again, you're going to open your source template and make those changes there. Once you have those changes incorporated, they become part of your template. So now when I launch a brand new assembly, looking over in my browser tree, I have a folder for virtual components. Now, this folder, I'm going to show you how to create that a little later as well. But you'll see I've got grease, I've got a maintenance manual, stretch wrap, product labels, palletization, packaging, extra parts bags, anything like that. And if you go to your bill of material, there's each one of those items called out. You also have that bill of material structure associated with them. Now, if there's some of these that you don't need for this particular assembly, okay, you don't have an extra parts packet for this particular design, that's fine. Just come in here and delete it. It's gone, no harm, no foul. And it's also out of your bill of material. So you could build your assembly template with all of these virtual components. And we do have some customers that have 40 and 50 different virtual components to cover all of their designs. And when they start a new assembly, they simply come in here and delete what they don't need for that design. Now, they might do that in the beginning or they might do that in the end of the design process. But bottom line, they have that capability to come in here and tweak what they need and don't need.